this is Dr. Karavan. Today I am going to be treating a scar that happened from a laser burn on Alex's forehead. This happened a few years ago. She's got some indentation as well as some post-inflammatory redness around the atrophic or indented scar. First, we're applying numbing. She will numb for half an hour to an hour, the longer the better. And then we're going to remove the numbing cream, cleanse her skin with alcohol and HibiCleanse. Next, we're going to start the lidocaine injection, which is going to numb the scar area and prep it so that she's comfortable for subcision. Subcision is where I'm going to take this pink needle that has a small blade on the edge of it, and it goes under the skin. She's completely numb. She doesn't feel any of this right now. And this blade goes under the scar, cuts all the fibrous bands that are holding down the middle of the scar, causing the indentation. And you can sometimes hear the fibrous bands even separating and cutting. After that, we're going to use some hyaluronic acid serum as well as her own platelet-rich plasma, which has all the wonderful growth factors to build collagen and restructure underneath that scar. We're going to treat her entire forehead, including that scar, with the microneedling. And within that scar, I'm going a bit deeper than where I would go normally for just rejuvenation. And this scar will turn very swollen, very purple and bruised, and that is normal. And she will repeat this a few times, ideally 3 to 4 times at least, about a month apart until the appearance of the scar is ideal. And then we will put a mask on her for hydration and to allow the PRP to seep into all the little holes that the microneedling device made, just for extra added benefits. She would sit here for about 10-15 minutes and relax. And after she's done, we'll put some Phyto corrective gel on her that will reduce the redness and swelling, and then put sunscreen on for her to go home. She won't wash her face until tomorrow with a gentle cleanser, and she'll go home with a kit that has hyaluronic acid serum, as well as a moisturizer that she will put on multiple times a day until her forehead is healed completely, and she will protect it really well with sunscreen throughout. So Alex is likely going to be bruised because of the subcision for probably 1 to 2 weeks. This area will be very purple and bruised up, but it will go down fast even within the first couple of days. She can wear makeup starting tomorrow and cover the area if she needs to.